There's a load of bungle out there on the internet about this case. Well, there's not actually. There's not that much out there. Apart from what I've been saying, you've only got an LBC mainstream so-called investigation into the disappearance of Vishal Mehrotra. And the mainstream articles from the press which say it's 33 years later and I believe Scotland Yard have covered up the death of my son. Now, if you want a quick rundown on what I believe happened to this little boy, here's what I think from the evidence that I've gathered. This little boy goes missing that day for certain. However he ends up on his own, I don't know whether their official events are real. They could be. But this boy ends up on his own. He then ends up round the corner because this area is the same area as where the Elm guest house is. Right? Now, Sidney Cook's fairground, you could have pissed on it from where Elm guest house was. And this boy is roughly in the same area. Right? He's roughly around that same sort of area. So the little boy goes off. Somehow, he's led to the fairground. Right? Somehow, this little boy's led to the fairground. He's led to the fairground, and then if there's any truth in Andrew's story, now you've got to remember this is 40 years ago, so Andrew's just a boy himself. And if he is being sort of looked after, I wouldn't really call it that, but if he's got Sidney Cook around him, which I definitely believe that part. Andrew's done something wrong in order for him to be getting bossed about by the police and getting and trying to set a pop star up, trying to set me up, right? So he's done something wrong. And there is a Sidney Cook involvement. And don't forget, one of Sidney Cook's gang used to live next door to me. That's a big point here, right? So, Vishal goes missing on the day of the royal wedding. I don't believe, my gut is telling me, the dad's not totally innocent in this. Now, the dad is a magistrate at the time, right? He's a magistrate. And in the interview in 81, he says, you know, I guess I should have inspected it. Now, it just feels a little bit remorseless. Even though he's got his head down and he's smoking on his pipe and it's a very early TV interview, you know, fresh after they've just found Vishal's body, which would have been dismembered, if I'm right, and they do say partial remains, right? And it was him, he was decapitated, right? It's him, I'm telling you it's him. And Andrew Ash has already admitted it. And I think this story may have a lot to do with why they are able to get someone like Andrew Ash to try and set someone like me up. But they got caught out in the process of it and they've said too much. So let's carry on, yeah? Let's carry on.
Sorry to interrupt, Dee said that your live's cut twice now.
My live's cut twice. Is it back on now?
I've just looked. You're on Just Be and you ain't on the other one. Mm. So, yeah, so just... Babe, YouTube is fucking with B stream. Everyone's messaging me saying your stream's... Right, I'm on now. Yeah, you're on now.
We are on.
I think... You're right, so straight away,
people, there's a problem, isn't there? Yeah? Straight away, we have
stops,
a problem.
Then you have to come off it again. It's back. Fine now. Had to refresh.
Yeah, see?
Got 102 in this.
Right, this is what I'm saying to you people, yeah? This is a problem, and they know that I've worked it out and I have some truth here. Once again, I'm sitting here with the truth. And I'm going to point out all the contradictions in this documentary. So we're just going to carry on like this, all right? I know it might feel a little bit drawn out, but this is important. Number one, I keep stopping the video and talking, and it fucks up the algorithm. And number two, the bits that I'm saying are fucking so important here. They're so important. I can show you, I can see what they're doing here, right? So let's watch it, let's carry on.
Can do to help find some fact and cut through that noise.
And it strikes me that you were brought up in this part of London. Mm-hmm. In West London.
So, show me the kinds of roads that Vishal went missing for.
So this is the Upper Richmond Road.
Okay, so where's East Putney Tube in relation to here?
East Putney Tube is down that way.
Okay, so these are two really important pieces of geography in this story, because we know on that day, Vishal, his younger sister, Mamta, and their nanny had accompanied the children's father, Vishambar, to his office in Fleet Street to watch the royal procession.
Right, it's either an LBC or there's a thing online, and Ian Puddick funded episode 7 of it, and it's to do with this Vishal Mehrotra thing. It's online. It's an online podcast to do with the disappearance of this. And I'm going to point out the contradictions in this story and the story that you can go on and listen to yourself. It's not hard to find. And so the official story that I'd heard before I've seen this is that they're there, they're watching this, you know, all the crowds and everything to do with a royal wedding, and the nanny's with them, as they're saying here, right? But the difference in the story, which is coming up on this one, is that Vishal's father gave them some money and that they went over to the sweet shop. They completely miss that out in this story. And I think, you know, accuracy is everything when you're describing something like this. You're missing things out for a reason. You're keeping things vague for a reason. And don't forget, Channel 4, Hayley Barlow. All right, let's carry on.
They returned from Fleet Street to East Putney Tube about 20 to 2. Vishambar is very tired, and he wants to go back to the family home to get some rest.
Right, so I have heard this, that the dad goes off on his own and goes back to the house, leaving the two kids with the nanny. The dad gives them a pound or 50p or something to buy some sweets in the shop. They go in a sweet shop. This is not mentioned on here.
When they came out of the tube...
Pause that. They think that's interfering with the connection, maybe. That's what they're saying in the chat.
I don't...
Maybe what? Paul's that. It's not you, is it? You was playing yourself live.
Yeah.
Wait, I think because you've got so much going on, it might just be... as
what,
well.
Just turn that off?
Yeah, just... And then go back to that when you want to say about Andrew.
All right. It could be the Streamlabs app on the phone.
Why don't you just go live on if you're not...
Well, because you can't... So, because this is easier at the minute.
Okay.
Right, let's carry on.
Vishambar would have gone to the right, and the children turned left to come to this crossing on the Upper Richmond Road to go across the road to go buy some coffins.
Right, so the story there has changed. He just said that they went across the road to go and buy some cough medicine and showed you the picture of a pharmacy. When you listen to the other podcasters online, it won't be hard to find. There can't be many of them. They go across the road to a sweet shop. There's no mention of a pharmacy or cough medicine.
Well, they cross the road, but then Vishal decides that he's tired and he wants to go home to be with his father.
Vishal wanted to go to the sweet shop.
Homebush Road.
Homebush Road is past the station and to the right.
So why have they now changed the story and made it that Vishal wanted to go home to be with his father? Right, here's how my brain thinks. They are, these complete strangers to this family are now assuming, oh, Vishal's tired and he wants to go home to be with his father. Right, which is insinuating that he's very close to his father. He just wants to go home and be with his father. Imagine this. He doesn't want to go home and be with his father. His father's a wrong'un. He's a magistrate. And this geezer is into something that's got him in trouble and had his fucking child taken by people that are connected to Sidney Cook. Right? Keep that in your head.
And even though he was only 8, he regularly walked this road by himself.
Right, he was 8. He was 8. And Andrew Ash keeps trying to make me think that he's 10 and that he's mixed race. And when I put it on Andrew, he's not mixed race. He's got straight hair. I said, what, dark black straight hair? He said, yeah. Right? He was Indian. I said, what, he could have been Indian. Oh, he could have been Indian. So Andrew's flopping about.
So it's unlikely that he got lost on the way home.
Because he was confident about the route, that's why Vishenbar was so concerned that when he woke up at 5 o'clock that afternoon, that Vishal hadn't returned home.
Right, so these complete strangers are now making it okay for the father. These are the people that are putting the concern out there. He was so concerned. So that makes me think the opposite. That makes me think the old man is in on this, and you'll see his reaction when I play you the video in a little while of how he acted on the news, smoking his pipe and that. It's very unnatural, right? These complete strangers on this documentary, this Channel 4 documentary, are assuming a lot of things here. Yeah, and they're making this father out to be a loving father, which makes me think that they are covering up for him because it was the complete opposite. And this story is a lot deeper and a lot darker than we can possibly imagine.